Howdy folks. A while ago I treated a subject, and that is about coins and the chances that they are falling on their edge. Well, I've taken it to another level. Oh, that's my computer, I was waking up. I took it to another level, and I started to investigate. In the first place, I started to investigate fallen coins and treat them as if they increase their thickness, so becoming a rod. So what is the statistics of a rod falling on its edge, or head or tails, and head or coins? But I thought, okay, if you can have a rod, then you can also have something like a hollow rod. Well, and I've been experimenting a lot ever since with something very easy to manipulate and very easy to construct, with a rod that we all know after we finished our toilet paper. So what I did is I did some experiments with ordinary toilet paper rolls, and yeah, that may seem very because it's a rod as well, it's a hollow rod, but we assume that it's very evenly distributed in mass, and I wanted to see if this had the same statistical things, a distribution, if you do a lot of experiments with them as coins, or stacked coins, or glued coins together, and if they have the same statistical properties. And yes, they do. What I found the last time that I tossed coins and see the chance of ending them on their edge is that it's a log normal distribution. Well, what I basically did, I simulated the whole thing with toilet paper rolls, and I'm going to show you the series that I've been using. And I started with, let me show you here, I presented them here. I started with this series. Here you can see, I hope you can see them very clearly. Yes, I started with ordinary rolls and shortened them to about, well, a couple of millimeters, 5 millimeters. Stuff like that. So these are ordinary toilet paper rolls, so I could conduct this experiment at home in my own spare time and stuff like that. And I made a whole series, as you can see. And I tossed them over and to see whether they would land on the. I marked them with a circle and a cross. And I tried to figure out what the statistics are of these objects falling. If they land on their edge, if they land on their sphere circles, or on the cross, and stuff like that. So, and I did that for the whole series. And you get the same kind of statisticals, a log normal distribution from these kind of rolls. But then I thought, okay, what happens if I change the shape of these things and made different shapes, like, for example, like this. And so I also am busy with investigating what the statistics are of these rolls, because you get different. It can fall in on the cross, on the circle, or on the edge. And what is the statisticals of that? And I also took it further to some other experiments, and like this, if you change the mass distribution, so I took a circle from it, or I took two circles from it, on each side one, or even three circles from it, and stuff like that. So I started to experiment with all kinds of forms and mass distributions, and also including with this case it's tapes. These are sticky tapes stacked together. I bought this one in a shop. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 rolls of sticky tape. And I'm busy with this experiment, so I don't have much data on this yet. So I'm wondering, because here you can see that's a clear mass distribution difference between an ordinary roll and this one, because here you have some mass, more mass to the inner parts. So it becomes more of a rigid rod,
a rigid, more rigid tube. And so I'm wondering what is going to do to the statistics of the does it matter if it's just a hollow rod, or does it matter if it's a more solid rod? So I want to toss this one and see if it changes the statistics of it. And not only that, I can also do with conical shapes. I mean, like beakers, for example. And I am taking these beakers because these are conical, and so I'm also testing these things, and it may turn out that the statistics of these objects falling is different than of an ordinary rod, or for that matter, for a coin. This simulates a coin, because a coin, if you have this one, this is an ordinary 5-cent coin. A coin is actually basically nothing more than a very, very, very short rod. And I did the experiment with coins already, as you know. But this does it matter if it's a solid? Does it matter if it's a hollow thing? Does that matter? Does the shape matter? Does the mass density matter and stuff like that? What is determining the odds of a coin falling to its edge, or for this matter, a circular paper distribution on its edge? And I can tell you it's not zero. It's the statistical, there are some things, it says that it's a non-zero chance, and it's pretty big, actually, if you consider it, if you look at the experimental data, that it falls on its edge. And so I try to treat it a bit more further than just coins falling to their edge. And of course, you can also wonder about if it matters if it's, in this case, I mean, this is just a form, but does it matter to have, for example, a cube or dice, and what does the shape what does the shape have some influence on it, and stuff like that. For here, example, you have two forms, two things that you can this is an elongated form, and you can also shorten this to become a cube, and then you get in the area of dices. So I'm trying to investigate all kinds of forms to see whether the shape or the mass distribution is a bit different. And I did some experiments already, like I told you. I have to find it on my computer right now. One moment, please, and I can show you some starting up data. Hey, where is the mouse of the computer? Let's pull it out then. Let's see if I can work without a mouse. A bit of it, yeah. Hey, come on. No, I have to take the mouse. Sorry. One moment, please.